There are over 550 million firearms in worldwide circulation. That's one firearm for every 12 people on the planet. The only question is, how do we arm the other 11? There was always some gangster getting whacked in my neighborhood, but I'd never seen it with my own eyes. I had this knack of showing up 5 minutes before something went down, or 5 minutes after. Not that day. It hit me. It couldn't have hit me harder if I was the one who had been shot. You go into the restaurant business because people are always going to have to eat. That was the day I realized my destiny lay in fulfilling another basic human need. You go into the restaurant business because people are always going to have to eat. That was the day I realized my destiny lay in fulfilling another basic human need. The next Sabbath, I went to temple with my father. However, it wasn't God I was trying to get close to.
Eli, my eldest son, you.
My contact at synagogue landed me my first Israeli-made Uzi submachine guns. The first time you sell a gun is a lot like the first time you have sex. You have absolutely no idea what you're doing, but it is exciting, and one way or another, it's over way too fast.
Gentlemen, the new Uzi machine pistol. Big firepower in a small package. This little baby uses 9mm hull points, 20, 25 round extendable mags, rear flip adjustable sights. Silencer comes standard. Excellent recoil reduction. Muzzle jump reduced 40%, 60% improved noise suppression. You could pump a mag into me right now and never wake the guy in the next room. Of course, that would eliminate your opportunity for repeat business.
I did have a natural instinct for smuggling contraband. Fortunately, back then a video camera was as big as a bazooka. Here I'd been running away from violence my whole life, and I should have been running towards it.
That's him. That was a big shot. Simeon Morse. Angola, Mozambique, those Exocet missiles in the Falklands. He was selling guns before there was gunpowder.
Be right back.
Mr. Weiss? Mr. Weiss?
It's okay, they're talking. May I help?
Yes, a mutual friend, Eli Kurtzman from Brighton Beach, import-export, said to contact you. I have a business proposal, and I thought perhaps we could discuss it.
I don't think you and I are in the same business. You think I just sell guns, don't you? I don't take sides.
But in the Iran-Iraq war, you sold guns to both sides.
Did you ever consider that I wanted both sides to lose? Bullets change governments far surer than votes.
You're in the wrong place, my young friend.
There's no place for amateurs.
Curious how you always revert to your native tongue in moments of extreme anger. And ecstasy.
Oh, Boże. Boże mój! Boże mój!
You are beautiful. What's your name again?
The only option for Vitaly and me was under-the-counter gun running. I got my first break in Lebanon after the suicide bombing. But I wasn't the only local kid making good. When the United States leaves a war zone, they generally don't take their munitions. It costs more to bring it back than to buy new stock.
So, we sell by the kilo.
The second-hand weapons, but they're still okay.
How many kilos would you like?
5,000.
I had a flair for languages. But I soon discovered that what talks best is dollars, dinars, drachmas, rubles, rupees, and pounds fucking sterling. Of course, the U.S. Army got a piece of the action. Army salaries were no better in the 80s than they are today. And some of the brass, like Lieutenant Colonel Southern, needed to raise money for their own private wars.
Good to make your acquaintance.
This is bullshit money, V. This is small fucking potatoes.
What do you want to do, go more legit?
No, more illegal.
What I would give right now for a plate of cabbage and potatoes.